Hello, my friends. Hope you're all doing well, and welcome back to another Baldur's Gate 3 build guide. Today, I'm going to be taking you through the best assassin character in Baldur's Gate 3. An assassin character being one that intends to end fights before they even start by striking from stealth and doing overwhelming damage to the enemies, killing them before they ever get a turn. This is the actual build that I use for Astarion, so I'm going to be using him as the example character, but I think this is also an excellent build for a main character, and in fact one of the best builds for soloing Baldur's Gate, because you will end so many encounters before they even start from stealth without the enemies ever knowing you were there. If you do want to use this for a main character, I recommend choosing Deep Gnome, Drow, or Wood Elf as your racial choices. Drow because you can cast Darkness on yourself and stay hidden, Deep Gnome because you have a racial advantage on stealth checks, and Wood Elf because the +5 movement speed is incredibly valuable for every character. But let's take Astarion through this build. From levels 1 through level 8, I think, are very set, so I'm going to be building it up to there, and then after that, it's kind of dealer's choice as to how you want to finish off your last 4 levels. Now, you might think that we will be starting with Rogue, because that's the sort of natural point class for an assassin character, but in fact, for this build, we're going to be starting somewhere else. The class that you're going to start with at level 1 is the Ranger. There's a reason for that, which we'll talk about when we get to level 3, but for now, bear with me. So, with the Ranger, we get access to a couple minor bonuses here in terms of favored enemy. I recommend for this one either Ranger Knight, which gives you heavy armor proficiency. That seems a little counterintuitive because we intend to be sneaking. Heavy armor gives you disadvantage on stealth checks, but in this game, actually, having... you don't make a lot of stealth checks. You will typically stealth... Typically stealth is done just by avoiding enemy sight, so it's actually not a huge penalty to have heavy armor, and because we intend to have expertise in our stealth skill, we'll probably make a lot of the stealth checks that we're asked to make anyways, even in heavy armor. So Ranger Knight is good if you want to start off with heavy armor proficiency, though we will be getting that later. But probably the best one is Bounty Hunter, because disadvantage on the Ensnaring Strike save can be extremely valuable for making that happen, and Ensnaring Strike is a very powerful skill. Under the Natural Explorer option, I think the best one, you could go with Beast Tamer because familiars have a lot of uses, but probably the best one is Wasteland Wanderer for fire, just having fire resistance. It's a very efficient way to stop yourself from taking damage, and fire is the most common damage type in this game, and in Dungeons & Dragons in general. For our stat point spread, I recommend for Astarion that you go with... let me zero these all out. Get him to 16 Dex and 16 Constitution at least, and then probably 14 Wisdom, just as your other skill. This is just because Wisdom is the most important saving throw, and he won't be making Intelligence or Charisma rolls that often. Strength can be useful just for jump, distance, and carry weight. If this is for a main character and you want to have some conversation skills, you can move the points from Strength over to Charisma, and if you intend to use the way that you get to increase a stat by 1 relatively early in the game, which I won't spoil for you in case you haven't played that far, then you can pull these out and put that extra point into Dexterity and then do something like this. But for now, let's just assume that you've gone with this stat split. Because if you start with 17 Dexterity and then get the +1, then you can get yourself to 18. For your skills, the only ones that really matter are Sleight of Hand and Stealth. I recommend having Perception, but the rest don't matter. I think it's probably best to put the last one into Athletics, because sneaking up behind someone and pushing them into a pit is a good way also to end encounters before they even start, but mostly you just need Stealth, and of course Sleight of Hand is very useful for any character that wants to be stealthing around, and Perception will stop you from running into traps. For our second level, we will be taking an additional level of Ranger. And for our spells, we'll of course take Ensnaring Strike, because Ensnaring Strike is very powerful. An entangled enemy you have advantage against, so when we have sneak attack damage starting at level 4, that will allow you to trigger your sneak attack very easily, and of course it also keeps them in place, which lets you shoot them from range again. And Hunter's Mark is also probably very valuable, just increases your overall damage, sustained damage output in later rounds of a fight. Finally, for our fighting style, we'll be going with archery, since, of course, this is an archer build where we intend to kill people from a long distance. At level 3, we get the reason why we're in Ranger, and that is the Gloomstalker Ranger. So Gloomstalker Ranger is extremely powerful for basically one reason, and that's that this subclass feature. You get a +3 bonus to initiative, and on the first turn of combat, you get a 10 extra move speed, and you can make an attack that deals an additional 1d8 damage. I think this is actually a very badly written tooltip, because what it doesn't say is that this attack is an extra attack made as a bonus action. So where most characters have to wait until level 5 to get a second attack, the Gloomstalker Ranger gets an extra attack starting at level 3 with additional damage, so it makes your Nova potential really high. You will typically get an attack from stealth to start the encounter, and then you get your Dread Ambusher attack, giving you additional damage against an enemy. Our spell doesn't really matter, so probably just take Long Strider or Enhanced Leap. Leap can be very good to get to locations you otherwise wouldn't reach. And at level 3, we're going to deviate and go into Rogue. Rogue, of course, gives you sneak attack, so an extra d6 of damage against any enemy that doesn't know you're there or is threatened by an ally or that you have advantage against, all relatively easy conditions to trigger. And you get some expertise, and you get expertise in sleight of hand, which is extremely, or in stealth, which is extremely valuable since, of course, we're trying to hide. Rogue level 2 brings some cunning actions, but the cunning action hide is actually duplicated by a Gloomstalker feat. Both give you a bonus action hide. Still extremely useful, and cunning action dash is very good for repositioning, and disengage is a very useful safety tool, so absolutely great to have. Finally, at level 3 of Rogue, we get an additional sneak attack die, bringing our sneak attack up to 2d6, and we get the reason that we're in Rogue, the Assassin Rogue. The Assassin Rogue gets the initiative assassinate, so you get advantage on attack rolls against any enemy that hasn't acted yet, which is great because it lets you trigger sneak attack against enemies that haven't acted yet. But even more importantly, you get ambush. Any successful attack roll against a surprised creature is a critical hit, an automatic critical hit. Critical hits multiply any damage dice that you're rolling by 2, which means that your sneak attack dice are doubled, your weapon damage die is doubled, and your Gloomstalker bonus d8 is also doubled, and you can guarantee this on every attack. Let's put this all together, because level 6 is where this build really comes together. So in a typical encounter, you're going to have an opener shot that you make from stealth before the enemies know you're there. That opener shot will be, let's say you're using a heavy crossbow, which you get access to as a ranger, because you get martial weapons, so that's a d10, plus 2d6 of sneak attack damage plus your 3 dexterity for a total average damage of 15.5, maximum damage of 25. Then you get your Gloomstalker hit as a bonus action after combat starts because the enemy will be surprised. This is going to be a critical hit, and because the assassin's alacrity will have restored your action at the start of combat. Now, whether this lets you trigger your sneak attack again, I have found pretty inconsistent. Sometimes the game will give you the sneak attack a second time, sometimes it won't. If it won't, you want to save the sneak attack until after combat starts, because that's when you'll get the guaranteed critical. But for this math, I'm going to assume that it lets you do both sneak attacks, because it often will. So your Gloomstalker hit is going to be a d10 from your normal heavy crossbow with no enchantments, a d8 from your Gloomstalker hit, 2d6 from your sneak attack, and all of that is doubled, +3 from your dexterity, for an average damage of 37 on that attack, or a 63 maximum damage. And then you get your normal bonus attack, which is just a d10, but it's a critical because d10 +3, but it's a critical because you get 2 attacks with guaranteed criticals thanks to being a Gloomstalker, for 14 average damage or 23 max. That means in your opening Nova round against an opponent, you have an opening Nova of 71.5 average damage with a theoretical maximum damage in the first round of combat of 111. That's enough to kill pretty much anything except for even the toughest late game bosses in this game, and that's already available to you at level 6 with this build. This build, of course, is also totally fine before this combo comes online, but at level 6 you start doing incredible damage. But let's say that that's not enough for you and you want to increase your damage even more. The best way to do that, I think, is to then put levels into a third class, and that class is Fighter. Fighter gives you at level 1 doesn't do a ton for you, although Second Wind is never bad to have, and an extra armor from your fighting style is fine. You also get access to heavy armor and shields in case you happen to want them. Shield proficiency is really useful for archers in this game because you still get your AC bonus when you have your ranged weapon equipped, so you can just have a weapon and a shield equipped as your melee weapon and gain the shield bonus to AC, so that's a huge reason to have shield proficiency, even on archers. But at level 2, you get Action Surge. Action Surge allows you to take an extra action in your opening round of combat for another attack, which is also a bonus critical, because you are gaining an extra attack, because it's the enemy still has not acted yet and is still surprised when you action surge. So this gives you a whole extra critical hit, basically allowing you to increase the damage of your combo up to something like 130, with an extra attack feature, such as from a level 5 ranger or level 5 fighter, you can increase that even further by making additional attacks, and the action surge will give you two more extra critical hits. They won't trigger sneak attack, and they won't trigger the Gloomstalker damage, but you can crit your opponent something like 4 or 5 times. And the damage calculations that I did are just with a default, unenhanced, completely unenchanted heavy crossbow, which is very easy to find relatively early in the game, but there are also weapons that give you extra dice of damage, which are incredibly powerful for this build, because each of those dice is doubled every time you get a critical hit. Another thing that you can do is have a paladin ally cast radiant weapons on you for an additional d4 of damage, which is then doubled. Any flaming weapon, or there's some crossbows that provide a D4 of psychic damage, that will all be doubled as well. Incredibly powerful character, I think also very fun because you get to play around with the sight cones of enemies and one-shot them from stealth before they ever know you're there. A lot of the time, if you can just keep making your stealth checks, you can just keep hitting them from stealth before you even have to trigger your opening round Nova combo, but when you do, you will one-shot pretty much everything. Alright, my friends, I hope that you have enjoyed this look at this character. Oh, I guess I should actually mention one other thing. I think probably the best way to level this character is just to go to 4-4-4 in each class, because that will get you 3 feats, and your 3 feats will be 2 ability score increases to bring your dexterity up to 20, and the sharpshooter feat, which lets you reduce your chance to hit by 5 but increase your damage output by 10. That 10 damage won't be doubled by your critical hits, but since you intend to attack 4 or 5 times in the opening round, that's just an extra 50 damage, and since all your attacks will be made at advantage, the to-hit penalty is not particularly bad. Here, let me just pull that up. I also think that the fighter that you want to be is a battlemaster fighter, because then you can use maneuvers to trip enemies, to push enemies off of things. I think probably you want trip attack, precision attack, and pushing or menacing strike. Menacing attack, of course, does an additional d8 damage, which is also multiplied by your critical hits, and so that becomes, precision attack, menacing attack, and then either tripping or pushing or something along those lines, because menacing does an additional d8 of damage, frightens the target, trip attack does an additional d8, knocks them prone. Frightened is extremely good, because then the enemies won't be able to come towards you, and you can keep hitting them with your ranged attacks. At level 4, you get access to a feat. And I think that most of the time you're just going to want to boost your dexterity, but also really good for this build is Sharpshooter, giving you an additional
bonus 10 damage, and since you will be attacking something like 5 times in your opening round, once you get access to extra attack, that will be an additional 50 damage to your Nova at maximum level, or by level 11. Alright, my friends, I hope that you have enjoyed this look at my pick for the best assassin in Baldur's Gate 3. I think this build is super fun, super strong, will serve you very well. Great build for Astarion, great build for the main character. And as always, if you've enjoyed this video, definitely please leave a like and a comment. That helps a ton with the algorithm, and you can subscribe to my channel for more of this and other strategy game content. Cheers, my friends, and I'll catch you next time.